It comes from Vanuatu. That's in Oceania, with southwest of New Guinea. And it is made of a special material. This is all spider web. And I first thought it was something different, but because our spider web is a bit different, but this is very dense spider web. And they made a frame of plant material, and over that they put this spider web. These members of the secret society, the men, they are specialized in making contact with their ancestors, and these are very important for the group. You must imagine they had this on their head, this Janus, this double-sided face, and then there were all plant materials around in which they danced. It was, of course, when it was dark, there was fire, and it was really scary. Of course, they liked to scare the women mostly. Societies were only for male, and you could enter when you had enough pigs to buy yourself in. Then it was totally forbidden for all the other members of the people to know what they did and to look secretly. If you were caught in such a thing, you could even be killed. In time, the spider web was torn down here along these plant materials, and there had become a hole. Here it was broken, and I first did put fish glue on it, and I let it dry, and then I made also a patch of Japanese paper. That's a special thing. We work with Japanese paper, and we paint it in all kinds of different shades with Levafix paint, and that's a very big job because you make baths with the solution, with the dye, and then you have to put these papers into the bath so that they are painted into the fiber. So if we tear these little patches, the fiber is also painted, it has dyed. Like a kind of textile texture. So I could very softly pull this so it became higher, and I did at the backside, I did put patches of Japanese paper, and I pulled that over the plant material. And then in the end there were still some holes, and that you can see here. After I did glue the patches on the spider web, I put a bit of this material, you call it Tyvek, and it doesn't stick to glue. And then some blubber, which takes out the moist. And that's what you see here. At both sides I've done that. So now I'm going to take that off. And you see the result. You still see here that there is it hasn't become totally round, but well, this is how it now has become. This side is still more intact. It has these teeth. And there have been teeth before here. And if now I turn on, you see they are missing here and here. You see the spider web is still very flexible. The mask is filled with earth and pigment, which has also been broken down. It was had become very fragile, and I had to put on glue under it, and then sometimes I also took a bit of the Japanese paper, which I put on the glue. What I'm doing is testing if these pieces of paint are still fixed, or it looks like here it is a bit loose, so it needs a bit of glue. I first take some water ethanol. This is a boat model, and it is from, it's from Papua New Guinea. It has been treated before. I think the backside, this one, has been broken, and it has glued badly together. But we don't make everything too beautiful. This has been done again. And there was the previous conservator did make big supports of metal. It was put here behind the seal, and this one here was a support of metal, and it did look very ugly. And the speciality of these objects are that they are all made of natural materials. This is made of plant fiber, plant leaves, stems, pigments, but also resins. Resins are used, and the cordage is made of plant material, and that's I find very beautiful. That's what I like on these objects. And the metal was interfering with that. It didn't look natural. So we did look if we could take it away, and it was possible. So now it is more original.